Let's identify the differences in using the explore versus compare functions in PyDataLink to build reports based on event frames. These events functions were added to PyDataLink starting with PyDataLink 2014. And in a previous video, we saw how to use the explore function to create reports. And this brought up the question, when would you not use the explore function and instead use the compare function? The answer depends on whether or not you have child event frames. If you don't have child event frames, just stick with using explore. So child event frames, or also called child events, are used to break down events into sub-events that have different stages, say different parts of a process, a root cause for a downtime event. Child events, therefore, you can see, have to be associated to a parent event. In this example, I'm looking at mining trucks that are making round trips. And each round trip has different stages that are child events. There's a waiting for loading phase, a loading phase, running loaded, unloading, and running empty. And again, these are all set up as child events. If you want to look at child events grouped in this type of hierarchy, along with the associated parent event, just like is shown here in this report, you'll use the explore function. Let's take a look at the configuration for this. I'm going to do a left click to select and bring up the explore events options that were chosen. And we looked at how to configure this to do a lot of things in the previous video, but specific to child events, I want to bring your focus to the preview right here. We can use the preview to look at the hierarchy of the events and determine, are there child events, and how many levels of child events there are. I can use the plus sign to expand, and we can look at the child events and see that they're all one level below the parent event. To have them returned grouped in a hierarchy, the only option that I'll need to do is to specify the number of child event levels down here. You can see that the child event levels was selected as 1. Previously, when we were looking at things that didn't have child event frames, we left this at the default of 0. So this allowed us to look at the events in this hierarchy, a parent with children below it. But what if I only want to focus on the impact of a particular child event on the parent event? For example, I've heard that the performance during the running loaded phase has the biggest impact on the entire round trip meeting the expected duration. Now this is something to investigate. I don't really need to see rows of all the other child events. I just need to focus on a specific comparison. In order to do this, I'm going to use the compare function. And I have an example of what that looks like right here. In this type of report, I use the compare function, and now for each parent event, there's only this one single row as before, but information that is about the child event is listed here right alongside that of the parent. So you can see the information is presented on a single row, and you can tell what information is coming from the parent event as opposed to which information is coming from the child event, based on the syntax that's used. So right here, you can see that this is denoting that it's the parent information versus if it's coming from a child event, you'll see this type of syntax where it's indicating that this is a child event, specifically the running loaded child event. And now that I have the information organized this way, side by side, on a single row, the quick visuals I have added show me right away there's not a complete correlation between good performance in this running loaded child event and meeting the performance requirements for the road trip parent event. As a next step, I would do analysis to study the correlation, say using an XY plot in Excel. And I could make one of those very easily because the data is already in the right format for me to do that. Let's quickly take a look at how this can be set up. First, I'll need to select a cell where I want to start my event list. So I've got B5 selected. Then I'll choose the compare option. And the database looks good, and I'll use my cell references, having the start time be this cell reference and the end time being this cell reference, because I want to focus on looking at the round trips that occurred yesterday. And I want to look at the round trips that specifically occurred, so I'm going to need to select my template, the truck round trip template. And the only other option I'm going to choose is I want to focus on, under more search options, search mode, only the events that were entirely in the range of yesterday. Great. And in my preview, I see that same type of view, right? Which is reminding me this is exactly my parent and these are my children. I'll keep scrolling down. You might have noticed that all these options that we're choosing for the compare events, those were the exact same options we chose in explore events. In fact, the options are all basically exactly the same until you get down here to the bottom. Before, in addition to having the output cell, there was a specific option, another one, about choosing the child event levels. And this is not included for compare because we're bringing everything to the single row. Additionally, as I'm looking at all the potential columns to display, I'm going to reduce this down and look at only very specific ones for the parent that I'm interested in. And if you look down in the list, you can see that these are only the ones for the parent, but I want to bring in the attributes from that specific child event, the running loaded phase. How can I do that? To do that, I'm going to use this button right here. And this is going to bring in the possible attributes that I can add, and I can start to see through the hierarchy, I can pick the ones that I'm interested in. So I'm going to go to running loaded, and I'm going to be bringing in the duration, the engine RPM, and the driver. Those are the fields that I want to compare. Then I'll hit OK. And you can see this is the same thing that we were looking at earlier, bringing in those attributes that are specific to the parent and those attributes that are specific to the child on a single row for quick comparisons. To conclude, this is really the difference between the explore and compare functions, the formatting for how child event information is presented. Thus, if you don't have child events, just use the explore function. If you do have child events, make the choice. Choose explore for the hierarchical tree format and compare for the side-to-side format of your child events.